G'day guys, welcome to True Blue Touring. I'm Oscar.
I'm Ben.
And I'm Casty.
And on this episode, we head up to Broome, check out Cape Leveque and James Price Point.
Intro.
And that's it, okay, sick speaking.
Bloodstains won't make it, man, I got good things, got you. Arriving in Broome, we were quick to catch up with Cousin Jack and Uncle Craig, who were planning a trip out to one of Jack's spots near James Price Point. So we packed the cars up and then headed out there.
We aired down and followed the red dirt cliffs along for a while until we reached the beach. From there we went on to some mud flats where there was a little creek and Jack took us mud crab hunting. Alone again. They've always been so kind, but now they brought you away from me. I hope they didn't get your mind. Your heart is too strong anyway. We need to fetch back the time. Stolen from us. Now, won't you? We can bring it on the floor. Never danced like this before. We don't talk about it. We ended up getting 4 decent mud crabs for dinner that night, which was a great result. We then followed the track towards the water and had to cross over a few decent sized dunes on the way.
Only a couple hundred metres from camp, RANGA got stuck and started sliding towards the water. So we chucked the 4 max tracks under and that was enough to pop him out and get him going again.
While all this was going on, Jack tried to turn around to come and help the situation. But with the big boat on and in some soft sand, he actually also got stuck. But again, a couple of max tracks under that was enough to pop him out. Later that night, Jack's partner Jude rocked up with her 2 kids, Frankie and Josie. They got straight to work and found another 6 crabs, so we all ate really well that night.
The next morning, Jack went to launch the boat in the 200 and unfortunately he got bogged, so Jude went across in another 200 to get him out and she also got stuck.
Not to worry though, the mighty 105 was there, snatched out Jude, and then with a couple of match traps Jude was able to pull Jack and the boat back up onto the high ground.
Upon leaving James Price Point, we came across a bogged Nissan and he didn't look too stuck. I volunteered the 76 to pull him out, so he hooked up a snatch, gave him a little pull. He didn't seem to have his car on, so I gave him a bigger one and got him out.
Once we got back to Broome, unfortunately WARDY had to fly home for a wedding. Quite sad losing one of our valued members of the convoy.
Here's a little tribute to WARDY.
G'day guys, I'm WARDY.
The day after WARDY left, our group was restored to 6 with the arrival of my dad. We picked him up from the airport and then drove straight to Brits to pick up the hire car so he could join us for the next 2 legs of the trip. Much better, Andrew, I'm good with words.
The next morning we're up nice and early to get on our AOC fishing charter that Jim had kindly booked for us. It was a great day's fishing. We caught a heap of rock cod, blue striped emperor, remora and Spanish flag.
That's what I like. You
After a great day out on the fishing charter, we packed the cars ready to hit the road the next morning.
Next time on True Blue Touring, we head inland to check out the Pilbara region and explore the Karangini National Park. Also, just want to say a big thanks to Jack and Jude for hosting us during our time in Broome.
And to Jim and AOC Fishing Charter for a great day out on the boat.
I try my best to pretend that I'm not home, because I think you're better to forget. And then I hear the rocks against my window.